Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team. Today, I'm going to be discussing how we can use NX coatings to define paint and coating information in our parts and assemblies. We are beginning with a coffee machine. The part we are going to explore is the tamper on the inside. With this part already open in a new window, the first thing I'm going to do is click on the coating tab and additionally open up the Coating Navigator. The Coating Navigator is an excellent tool to keep track of all the different layers that have been applied to your part. To begin placing coatings on our part, the first step is to create coating regions where we want to attach our layers. To do this, we must select the Coating Regions tool and follow the prompts to set up a boundary that makes sense for our part. To begin, I'm going to select the face of the tamper so we can add a steel plate. Once that is finished, we can now add a coating layer. When adding a layer, we are given the option to name the layer, select a material, choose a thickness, and select a display color. When the material is chosen, thickness and color will be automatically set based on the material settings. These options are still customizable if these settings do not meet your design needs. With our steel plate now added on the end of the tamper, the next thing I want to do is add paint to the rest of the part. To do this, we will need three more layers, one for primer, the paint itself, and a clear coat. The first step will be establishing a new coating region. For this example, I'm selecting all of the area on the part that is currently green. Once set, the next thing I want to do is establish a separate coating stack for our paint layers, since it is applied in a different region than our steel plate. To do this, I'm going to use the coating stack tool. This is a great way to keep complex assemblies organized when lots of coating layers are applied. With our new stack now created, we can begin to add our new layers for the primer, paint, and clear coat. Using coating layers is a great way to convey which areas will have surface treatments applied during the production process. As we get to the clear coat, one important thing to note is that there is a clear coat checkbox in the coating layer window. By selecting this box, the new layer will go on with no color, making the layers below visible as before. The last thing I want to point out before finishing is that now in our coating navigator, we can see the different effects our layers have made to the part. Here we can see the new layer's thickness, applied volume, mass, area, center of mass, and density. These values can be used to calculate and determine the amount of coating material needed for procurement. Additionally, an accurate mass impact can be determined by investigating this information. In conclusion, in this video, we explored how to apply surface treatments to our parts. We began by defining our work area using the coating region tool. After that, we applied different coating layers to fit our product needs, while staying organized with the coating stack tool. And lastly, we looked into how we can investigate the different mass properties of our coating layers. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.